So now we start with our last talk in the series of fetal heart assessment during anomaly scan, which is a three-vessel trachea view. We saw the checklist of our four-chamber view, which was pretty big, but we have mastered it now. We have seen the checklist of our outflow tract views. So once you have done these two views, we come to a three-vessel view. A three-vessel view is obtained in a transverse plane of the fetal upper thorax. One has to move the transducer little cephaloid from the four-chamber view to obtain this three-vessel view. What you see in this view is the main pulmonary trunk appears in an oblique section. The ascending aorta and the superior vena cava are seen in a transverse section. So in short, when you start in the upper thorax, this is the right side, this is the spine, and this is the left side. So when you start from right to left, this is a smaller circle, that is the SVC. Then you see the aorta, which is a relatively bigger circle as compared to SVC. And then you see a comma-shaped structure, which is a pulmonary artery. So you move little more cranial to the three vessel view, and then you start getting a three vessel trachea view. Here you will see the aortic arch and ductal arch merging together with an acute angle between them. Both the arches are located to the left of the spine and trachea, and this is an important anatomic landmark. Color Doppler reveals the anteroposterior flow in both arches, and normally there should be no vessel crossing posterior to the trachea. So when you see here again, this is the spine. This arrow points to the trachea. This is the SVC, aorta and pulmonary artery. And this is the arch. This is the aortic arch and this is the ductal arch. So they usually form a V-shaped structure like this, which is to the left of spine and to the left of trachea. So this is an important landmark in the three-vessel trachea view. So if you put on the color, it usually shows anteroposterior flow. What do you mean by that? This is the spine, which is posterior, and this is the sternum, this is the anterior portion. So the blood flow always goes from the ventricles to the great arteries, and that's why they go posteriorly, and that's why since this is the color scale, you are seeing both these arches in the same color, and that is in blue. The SVC will be seen in red because it moves, it takes the blood in the opposite direction. And then you see the normally running subclavian artery on the right side, which in fact forms a cycle handle kind of a picture or kind of a configuration. So the abnormalities which can be picked up on a three-vessel trachea view can be abnormality in the vessel size, abnormality in the vessel arrangement and the alignment, the abnormal vessel number, it may be abnormal location of the transverse aortic arch in relation to the trachea, it may be abnormal functional behavior of the arterial vessels, that is a reversed flow or a turbulent flow, and that will be seen only using a color Doppler. So this is something which tells you about the size of the vessels. This is the spine here, this is the SVC, aorta and the pulmonary, and this is the trachea here. So here we know for sure that the aorta is small in size. This is another patient, this is the spine, this is the right side. You can see only two vessels. This is the SVC and this particular structure is the aorta, and this in fact has an abnormal configuration or an abnormal shape. It is in an oblique or a curved kind of a fashion. So then again, this tells you that there is something wrong with the outflows and you should scan the outflow tract views more carefully. This is the SVC, the aorta and the pulmonary artery. In fact, they should form a V, which is to the left of the trachea. Instead of that, they are forming a U kind of a structure behind the trachea. Normally, you don't see anything going behind the trachea. So this is a right-sided aortic arch. This, as we saw, that the flow in the three-vessel trachea view is always from the anterior to the posterior direction. So the pulmonary artery is showing a proper direction of the flow, but the aorta is showing a reversed flow. That means it is filling through the ductus arteriosus. This particular structure where they meet is the ductus arteriosus. So there has to be something wrong in the left ventricular outflow tract or something wrong with the left ventricle. Then there are some miscellaneous structures which can be seen on three vessel trachea view. It is aberrant right subclavian artery. We can do assessment of thymus in the three vessel trachea view, and we can do aortic isthmus Doppler velocimetry in FGR fetus. As you can see here, this is again the SVC, aorta and pulmonary, and this isoechoic structure, a box kind of a structure which is seen here, is the thymus. So this gets outlined by these two internal mammary arteries. This is the sternum here. So this is called a thigh box. This was described by Palladini. And this particular structure tells you that the thymus is normal because it forms a box kind of a structure. So that is a thigh box. The aberrant right subclavian artery is something like this. You can see the pulmonary and aorta, and this is the ductus arteriosus, and it is to the left of the spine, but you will see a vessel which is going behind the trachea. That's why this is the aberrant right subclavian artery. So this comes to the end of our series of videos about the fetal heart assessment during anomaly scan. The four chamber and three vessel trachea view are easy to obtain, and outflow tract views can be learned with practice. Thank you.